Book of Ephesians, chapter 2, 1 through 10. The title is Let's Not Betray Jesus Christ, Grace. Okay, we read Ephesians chapter 2, verse 1 through 10. This Bible portion, actually, we are very familiar. We know very well. This Bible teaches us how we can have a salvation, how we can be saved. It's not by our work. It's not by keeping the law. It's not because we are righteous. It's a totally grace of God through faith in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Actually, we are not qualified. And we have not done any really good things. We are not deserved to have that. But our Lord Jesus Christ, He did everything. And Jesus Christ has given us the salvation of our soul as a free gift. That's a grace of God. Amen.
Yeah.
We are all sinners. So because of sin, we should pay for that through going to hell and being punished forever and ever. And because of sin, we supposed to have many causes of life, many problems in this world, sickness and disease and poverty and no peace in our heart, broken relationship, many kind of problems we supposed to have because we are sinner. Sin generate, sin produce all kind of problem to our life. Our problem is we not able to solve our sin problem with everything we have. Sin is a spiritual thing. We are physical being. That's why we are not able to solve our sin problem. Jesus Christ knew that, and Jesus Christ loved us. So He is God of the whole universe, but He abandoned such a all privilege and glory, comfort in heaven as a God. But He came to this world and became human being, and He voluntarily and willingly, personally chose the way of going to the sacrifice. He gave himself to the enemy to be arrested, and he was terribly treated. He experienced suffering, hardship, all kind of the terrible treatment, and finally he was killed on the cross with terrible pain through Jesus Christ's sacrifice on the cross. Finally, all cost for our sin able to be paid. We able to be forgiven our sin, and we able to be saved. Amen. We didn't do anything for the solution of our sin. Jesus Christ did everything. Because of our sin, He experienced all suffering, and finally, He was killed on the cross. Because of sacrifice of Jesus Christ, we are able to be forgiven our sin, and we are able to be saved, and also we are able to be liberated from all causes of life. So, once again, we have not done anything for the forgiveness of our sin. Only our Lord Jesus Christ did everything. Amen?
Amen.
Now, anyone who believe that Jesus Christ is God, but He loves us, He died on the cross, and He was resurrected from death 3 days after His death. If we believe that, if we repent our sin before Him, if we accept Jesus Christ as God and Savior and Lord, our sin can be forgiven. We can have eternal life. We can be liberated from all causes of life. Amen?
Amen.
It's a free gift from our God. Today, Word of God, verse 8 and 9 here say, "For it is by grace you have been saved through faith. And this is not from yourself. It is a gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast." Yeah. So, our salvation, the forgiveness of our sin, liberation from causes of life, we become children of God, we enjoy all abundant life, blessed life. It's not from us. It's not because of we are righteous. because we because of it's not by our works. It's totally by grace of God. It's totally by what Jesus Christ did on the cross. It's a free gift given to us. So we cannot boast anything, but Jesus Christ did everything. Amen. Amen. Once again, let's remember what today Wojcicki said. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourself. It is a gift of God. Amen. Amen. Even faith in Jesus Christ, not from us. If we see 1 Corinthians chapter 12, there are a list of fruit of Holy Spirit. It's a list of gift of Holy Spirit. Among the gift of Holy Spirit, one of gift of Holy Spirit is faith. Even faith in Jesus Christ, not come from us. It's from our God. Amen.
Amen.
In our family, some family member, no matter how much we say about gospel, no matter how much we persuade them to believe in Jesus Christ, to be saved, but still not believe in Jesus Christ. We don't know why. But we, when we heard the gospel, we were able to believe in Jesus Christ. We were able to have a faith in Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
We don't know why, but we were able to believe that. Huh? But somebody, even no matter how much we say, persuade, they don't believe. That's why even faith in Jesus Christ, not from us, but from our God. It's also grace of God. It's a gift to our God, toward us. Amen?
Amen.
So, our salvation is not from us. It's totally grace of God, totally by grace of God, through faith in Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Not by works, not by keeping the law. It's a grace of God. Our God has given us His salvation to us as a free gift. Amen?
Amen.
So today, beloved Apple Birds, as a people who are given eternal life and the various blessing, abundant life, as a free gift, as a by grace of God, let's think about that. What kind of life we should live? If we remember that we are given our salvation through by grace of God, what kind of life we should live? Let's share about that. And also, below the Apple verse, we are so blessed, and also we admit that it's a grace of God. We become to come here, such a nice place, and we become to worship our God in this very beautiful, wonderful God's temple. And also, not only this temple itself, this place is surrounded by very wonderful environment, park and school and, good parking place, and very near from public transportation, everything satisfy us. Really, we are so blessed. We become to come here, and we become to worship our Lord Jesus Christ in this kind of place, in this wonderful temple of God. It's a totally great grace of God. Amen.
Amen.
We are given really a big grace of God. So if we remember that, we are given such a wonderful grace of God through this nice temple, nice God's temple. If we remember that, what kind of Christian we should be here in this wonderful church? If we remember grace of God, what kind of people of God we should have? Let's share about this today, through today's words of God. Okay, if we see Book of John, chapter 8, verse 1 through 11. One woman, she did adultery at the spot where, at the spot where she committed adultery, she was found by people, and also she was arrested, and she was brought to Jesus Christ, and people accused her to Jesus Christ. This woman committed adultery and arrested at the spot. According to the Moses law, this kind of woman deserved to be stoned to death, supposed to be stoned to death. But what you gonna do to this woman? They wanna test Jesus Christ. That's why they made a question to Jesus Christ. To their question, what Jesus Christ say? Jesus Christ say, if you don't have any sin, first throw stone at her, against her. If you don't have any sin, you throw stone against her. Jesus Christ write like this on the ground. And when people saw that what Jesus Christ wrote on the ground, they feel guilty in their heart. Why? Because they also all sinners. They also did many wrong things. There's nobody who don't have a sin at all. That's why what they did, they finally dropped their stones and they all went away from that place. Only Jesus Christ and the woman left behind, remained there. And at the time, Jesus Christ said to this woman, go now and live your life of sin. Yeah. Actually, this woman become to be saved from the from the situation of being killed through being stoned to death. But Jesus Christ saved us, saved her through saying, if you don't have a sin, you first throw stone against her. Because of Jesus Christ, this woman was saved. She was given special grace of being saved, being spared her life. Amen? Amen. To the woman who are given special grace by Jesus Christ said, go now and live your life of sin. What does it mean? You are saved because of grace of God. And if you are, remember that grace from now, please don't live the simple life anymore. Amen? Amen. Don't live the simple life anymore. Yeah. Beloved parables, we are same. We are all sinner. So because of sin, we are all supposed to be punished in the hell forever. Amen? Amen? But like this woman, we are given special grace. Jesus Christ sacrificed himself on the cross. Because of Jesus Christ's sacrifice on the cross, we are able to be forgiven our sin. We are able to be saved into eternal life. Amen? Amen. We are same like this woman. Given special grace of God. Amen? Amen. If we remember that, if we remember this special grace of God of saving us, what kind of life we should have? Like what Jesus Christ said to this woman, we also should live away from simple life. Amen? Amen. We should not live simple life anymore. Amen? Go now and live your life of sin. Jesus Christ experienced all suffering on the cross because of our sin, for the forgiveness of our sin. Jesus Christ experienced all, Jesus Christ was killed on the cross because of our sin. And because of suffering of Jesus Christ, because of Jesus Christ's sacrifice on the cross, we are able to be forgiven our sin, and finally, we are saved. If we remember that, if we remember that grace, what kind of life we should live? We should live holy life, righteous life, sanctified life. Amen? Amen. Of course, we are weak and deficient. We are willing, but we make many mistakes. We stumble. That's why we continually should rely on power of Holy Spirit. Amen? Amen. Continually we examine life. We repent our sin. And also we seek for being filled with the Holy Spirit. We seek for Holy Spirit is controlling our life. Holy Spirit's work of sanctification for our life. Amen. Amen. And through rely on the power of Holy Spirit, we should seek for holy and righteous life, sanctified life. Amen. Amen. It's the proper life. It's the people who are saved by grace of God. Amen. Amen. Beloved believers, we are given special grace that we come here, very beautiful church, beautiful God's temple. And also, not only our church is beautiful, our surrounding of this church is also very, very beautiful. Beautiful park, left side, the school also beautiful. All our surrounding is beautiful, fresh, quiet, very opposite to the place where we worship in the past, all the church. Anyway, we are so blessed. Not only church is beautiful, not only church is a nice place, our life also should be beautiful. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah. Our life also should be holy and righteous, and also sanctified life. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, second, what kind of life we should live as a people who are given God's special grace? We are given special grace of being led to this beautiful temple. If we remember that, this grace of God, what kind of life we should live while we are worshiping here? If we see Book of Luke, chapter 17, verse 11 through 19, there were 10 lepers. They were whole life lepers. So they suffer so much. And they really desire to be healed. They desire to have a normal life. Because of leprosy, they could not get a job. They could not mingle with normal people. And also, they are suffering because of various physical problems caused by the leprosy. So they really desire to be healed, to be cured, and to have a healthy and normal life. One day they heard the news that Jesus Christ healed every sickness. So they decided to come to Jesus Christ and ask help for being healed for their problem, leprosy. So these 10 lepers, they came to Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ said to them, show your body to the priest. You go to the priest and show your body. That's Jesus Christ's direction for the healing of these 10 lepers. So these 10 lepers, when they were given this direction from Jesus Christ, they immediately defiled for priest to show their body to them. Even they don't reach the priest, even they don't show their body to the priest, just on the way to meet the priest, their leprosy totally healed. Amen? All 10 lepers, their leprosy totally healed. They became totally clean. They were given special grace of God. Whole life, they were lepers. So suffering. But when they met Jesus Christ, when they given direction from Jesus Christ, when they did according to the direction of Jesus Christ, their problem, whole life problem, totally solved. Amen?
Amen.
They didn't do anything for the healing of their leprosy, the total grace of God, grace of Jesus Christ, that they will solve their whole life problem. Amen?
Amen.
After they were given this special grace of God, what they should do? Definitely, they should come back to Jesus Christ. Definitely, they show their thanks to our God. They should thanks their thanks to Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah, but nine Jewish lepers, they just disappeared. They didn't come back. They didn't show any thanks to Jesus Christ. They didn't worship to Jesus to God for expressing their thanks. They just disappeared. Only one Samaritan leper. Brother Pilbers, in the time of Jesus Christ, we should understand how Samaritan, they were treated. Actually, Jewish people, they have a very strong pride of being Jewish, being Israel person. being Jews. Why? Jews means chosen people. Amen? So these Jewish people, they thought that we are chosen people. We are people of God. But non-Jewish people, they are all pagan people. They are all pagan. They are excluded people from God's salvation. They even thought them as a human. They never tried to mingle with them. It's what Jewish people, their concept, their thinking about themselves and others, non-Jews. You know, Samaritan. Samaritan means the Israel people who live northern area of Israel. After King Solomon died, Israel was divided, northern Israel, southern kingdom of Judah. And northern Israel, you know, invaded by the foreign nation frequently. So the northern Israel people, their blood mixed with pagan people, Gentile people, a lot. Because that area frequently invaded by Gentile people. So Gentile people, you know, live there. They emigrated to northern Israel, and they took many northern Israel people to their nation. Through those situation, northern Israel people, their blood was not pure blood of Jewish people. They were mixed blooded people with Gentile people. And southern kingdom of Judah, the Jewish people, whoever pure blood of Jews, they didn't treat the Samaritan. Yeah, Samaritan means the people of northern Israel, because the capital city of northern Israel was Samaria. The pure-blooded Jewish people never treated Samaritan as a same Jewish people. They treated them as like Gentile people, and they don't try to mingle with them, and they don't even try to eat together. It's what pure-blooded Jewish people thought toward Samaritan people. Even this Samaritan leper, he was disfied, he was treated like that, but when he was given special grace of God, even though the other nine all pure-blooded Jewish people, Jewish lepers, they all disappeared, they all just went away, even they were given special grace of God, only one Samaritan leper, when he was given special grace of God, what he did? He come back to Jesus Christ. Amen? He prostrated himself before Jesus Christ, and he worshiped God. To give thanks to God, to worship God, to express his thanks to our God. Amen? He said to Jesus Christ, "Jesus Christ, really thank you so much. I was a whole life leper, but now I'm healed. It's totally by grace of God. Thank you so much for healing. I praise God, I worship God, I give glory to God." Only one Samaritan leper come back and express his thanks to our God through worship to our God. Amen? Amen. Beloved believers, like this Samaritan leper, we also, as a person who are given special grace of God, what should we do? We actively come to our God and worship our God. Amen? Amen. Yeah. Not only this Samaritan lepers, we are also given special grace of God. Yeah? Beloved believers, we are all sinners, and also because of sin, we also have a various problem of our life. That is called the curses of life. But totally grace of God, totally because of Jesus Christ's sacrifice on the cross, we are able to forgive our sin, and we are able to have an eternal life, and also we are able to be liberated from all curses of life. Amen? It's not by our works, it's not from us, it's not by our righteousness, totally by grace of God. Amen? Amen. If we remember that, what we should do? We continually come before God, and we should worship our God, through which we should express our thank to God. We should give glory to Him, like this Samaritan leper. Amen? Beloved people, this time, once again, we are given special grace of God that we are given such a nice church building like this. But even though we are given nice church building, if we don't worship well here, if we don't pray ardently here, what news? This beautiful church building. Amen? It's not for, you know, just, you know, enjoying, or it's not for only fellowship. It's not place is only for the fellowship. It's not for only other purpose. Our God has given this wonderful church building to us to worship our God well. Amen?
Amen.
To pray continually, ardently, actively. Amen?
Amen.
That's why if we remember our grace of God, if we remember special God's grace toward our church, that we are given very nice church building, what we should do? We actively, continually gather together in this house of God, and we should worship our God well. We should give very nice, good worship to our God. Amen?
Amen.
Are you okay? Not hot? If hot, let's turn on the aircon. If we don't use our aircon when we are hot, one use that one. Aircon, there is aircon to use when we are hot. And also, build up your verse. By grace of God, we have been saved. And by grace of God, we are enjoying various blessing in our life, abundant life. And also, by grace of God, we are here, wonderful church. If we remember that, what kind of life we should live? Another thing, through the word of God. Let's see. If we see book of Matthew chapter 18, 21 through 35, Jesus Christ say this parable. There's one, you know, master and one servant. Actually, one servant had a huge debt from one master, 10,000 talents. It's a really huge money. And this servant, even though he worked whole life, never be able to pay back this huge debt. One day, this master called this servant and asked to pay for the debt. But the servant never able to pay back. So this, so the master say, if you cannot pay back the debt, then you sell your family, your wife, your children, and pay back even some. And this, then this servant became very desperate and ardently begging. Begging to master, please mercy on me. How can I sell my wife and my family? I love them so much. Please mercy on me. Please forgive me. When this servant who owed huge debt from the master, when he ardently pity on him, ask pity from master, this master is very generous and also very merciful. So what he did, he accept the servant's petition, and the master just cancel all these huge debt. It's a very huge debt, 10,000 talents. It's a huge money, but just one time, this master canceled all his debt. So this servant became free. Then, this servant, what he should be, what he should do, because he was given huge grace from this master, he also practiced that grace to other people, his neighbors. But after he was canceled this huge debt, after he was given this huge grace from his master, while he was going back to home, in the in the middle of going back his home, he met another fellow servant who owed only just some denarius. It's a very small money comparing to his debt, 10,000 talent. It's almost nothing. But this servant, as soon as he saw the fellow servant who owed only some denarius, he rushed to him and he grabbed his neck and choked him and threatened him, pay back my money. If you don't pay the, my money, I'm gonna put you into prison. He choked him and strongly threatened him. And the fellow servant asked mercy from him. Friend, please, mercy on me. And please wait just more days. I'm gonna pay back the money to you. But this servant never be merciful to fellow servant. He never tried to share grace that he received to this fellow servant. He didn't listen what fellow servant request. Immediately he put the fellow servant into jail. Later, the master who canceled huge debt of this servant become to hear what this servant did. He was very angry, enraged, and he command his subject, I cancel huge debt. I cancel his huge debt. Then he also should forgive others. But he never practiced any mercy to other fellow servant. How he can do like that? Master was very angry, and master command his subject to take him to the prison. And the master say, the unmerciful servant never be able to come out of prison until he pay all money. Yeah, actually, he cannot pay the money at all. It means that he cannot able to come out of the prison. He never be able to come out of the prison. Yeah, never. So Jesus Christ say about this parable, and Jesus Christ say that this is how my heavenly Father will treat each of you unless you forgive your brother or sister from your heart. Yeah, so through saying this parable, Jesus Christ say, if we don't forgive others, our God also not forgive us. Amen. Actually, we are given huge grace of God from our God first. We are all sinner, and because of sin, we should be punished in the hell forever. But our God sacrificed his son, only begotten son Jesus Christ, through which we are able to be canceled all our debt. We are able to be forgiven all our sin. We are given huge grace from our God. Then we also should practice grace to others. Amen. We also forgive others. It's what we should do as a person who are given special grace from our God. Amen. Just as our God was merciful, gracious, generous to us, we also should be same to others. Amen. Below that verse, especially this time, we are given special grace that we are able to come to this nice church, wonderful church. But below that verse, we should remember, among many internet churches, here in Pyeongtaek, other places, there are many typical churches. Once a month, the internet church pastors gather together, and we have a prayer meeting together. Whenever we have a prayer meeting once a month, we visit different churches, and there we worship and pray together, and we have fellowship. When we visit the churches of internet churches here in Pyeongtaek. I have seen that most of the church very small, only 20 pyeong, 30 pyeong, 40 pyeong, not only 1 or 2 years, many years. Even they did ministry 20 years. Same floor, same church, same size, continually. In Gongdo, there is a Elim International Church. Our pastor, Reverend Yu Yong-gu, he's 15 years older than me. That church started together with us, 2003. Just one floor, second floor, around the 40 pyeong. That church is near from our Deacon Juliet Chisanim house, near. Now 20 years passed, but same place, same size. The church, our pastor, his desire was, for 20 years, his desire was having a shelter. Because if there is a shelter, believers stay near and can join worship, Bible studying easier, more actively. That's why he wanna have a shelter for 20 years, but still they don't have a shelter. Only one floor, 40 pyeong, 20 years. Not only that church, most of internet churches, same situation. Smaller than that, less than that, you know. Our church, so blessed. So blessed. Amen. Really. We already used three floors. And even now, now we are more blessed. We use such a huge place, nice shelter, nice environment. We are so blessed. next week, Wednesday, international pastor in Pyeongtaek area, they will gather together our church. And we'll have a prayer meeting. Why? Because we newly moved to new church. So they want to come and they want to see, they want to bless this church. I think maybe some pastor may be shocked to maybe paint, surprise, and some pastor maybe too much surprise and shock and they became unconscious. Because there is no church like this among internet churches. Maybe we need to prepare ambulance. Why I say this? Anyway, we should remember. We are so blessed. Amen?
Amen.
Then what we should do? Because we have done good, our God has given this amazing grace. Actually, it's just the grace of God. Amen?
Amen.
We not deserve, we are not covered, but we don't know why. Our God has given special grace to this church. Amen?
Amen.
Then what we should do? We should remember our hard time in the past. Amen? And also we should remember that many other internet churches, they are much, much harder than us. Much, much poorer than us. Much, much difficult than us. Amen? As a church who have a better situation than them, as a church have a more blessing than those churches, what should do? Even not big, even small, we try to share our blessing to them. Amen?
Amen.
We try to share our grace to them. Amen? Even small, we try to help those still very small and poor, difficult churches. Amen?
Amen.
Just this word of God say. This servant, huge debt, canceled by master. Then he also should have shared his grace to others, but he didn't do that. Just some denarius, fellow servant who owed some denarius, he didn't forgive. He, you know, punished him, putting him into jail. Our church not only tried to be better, only our church, we remember our hard time in the past, we remember that there are many other poorer churches, more difficult churches, harder churches. Amen?
Amen.
So whenever God bless us, we try to share even small for them. Amen. Try to help them, missionaries and also pastors, churches and believers of the churches that harder than us, poorer than us, more difficult than us. Amen. We should share our grace to others, our neighbors. Amen. Actually, our church every month support 5 missionaries, even not big. 4 missionaries, 100,000 won, and 1 missionary to Mongolia, 200,000 won. Sometimes we cannot stop because we also hard sometimes, but they are harder than us. They are harder than us. Comparing to them, still we are blessed. Amen. That's why we should not stop. Amen. No matter what, we try to continue to help them. Amen. Actually, we should help more. We pray. We pray for that. We pray for that. We can help more. More churches. More missionaries. More pastors. Amen. Because we are given special grace. Then we also should share that grace to others. Amen? Amen. It's what we should do as a people who are given special grace from our God. Amen? And also, what we should do as a people, as a Christian who are given special grace from our God. If we see Book of Luke, chapter 8, 1 through 3, and Mark, chapter 16, 9 through 11, you know, Mary Magdalene, Mary Magdalene, she's the woman who are given special grace from our God. Actually, she was the woman who are possessed by demon, 7 demons, not one demon, 7 demons. So she was insane, crazy, mad, and because of possessed by demon, you know, she's suffering so much. She had a miserable life. But by grace of Jesus Christ, you know, those 7 demons were expelled from her. She became normal. Amen. Amen. She became free from 7 demons by grace of God, grace of Jesus Christ. Amen. After that, after she was given this special grace of God, what she did? She devoted her life actively to Jesus Christ. Amen. Wherever Jesus Christ went, she always followed. Yeah? The place Jesus Christ teaching, she was there. The place where Jesus Christ healing people, helping people, she was there. Where Jesus Christ went for evangelism, she was there. When where Jesus Christ do some other activity, she was there. Wherever Jesus Christ, she followed. Because she was so thankful the grace of Jesus Christ given to her. Healed from the possession of 7 demons. She actively devoted herself to Jesus Christ. When Jesus got arrested, you know, all disciples whom Jesus Christ really loved, whom Jesus Christ really take care of, all run away, all abandon Jesus Christ, forsake Jesus Christ. But this woman, Mary Magdalene, continually follow Jesus Christ. In the place Jesus Christ in the place where Jesus Christ had a trial, she was there. In the place Jesus Christ was whipped, she was there. In the place where Jesus Christ was crucified, she was there. When Jesus Christ was buried, she was there. Even the day Jesus Christ was resurrected, she came to Jesus Christ's tomb to serve Jesus Christ's body with oil. Likewise, Mary Magdalene, after she was given special grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, she fully devoted her life to Jesus Christ and tried to serve Jesus Christ devotedly. Amen? So, because Mary Magdalene, she devoted herself so actively and she tried to serve Jesus Christ so actively. That's why she was so honored. You know, after Jesus Christ was resurrected, Jesus Christ showed his resurrected body body, Jesus Christ showed his resurrected body as a first. Actually, Jesus Christ could show her body, his body to his mother Mary or his some other people, but as a first, Jesus Christ showed his resurrected body to whom? To Mary Magdalene, this woman who actively devoted her life to Jesus Christ after experience Jesus Christ's special grace. Amen? Amen. We also should be same. We are also like all Mary Magdalene. You know, we are all sinner, and because of sin, we are slave of Satan, slave of sin. Our life so afflicted. We are slaved by Satan, slave of sin, no freedom. But Jesus Christ, through sacrifice on the cross, He make us free. He forgive our sin. He has given eternal life. He changed our spiritual status from slave of sin and Satan into children of God. Amen? Amen. If we know this grace of God, what should we also should be same like Mary Magdalene. Amen? We should actively give, devote our life to Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen? We actively should devote our life to precious work of God. Amen? Amen. Like Mary Magdalene. Okay. Build up your verse. How we can devote, for what we should devote our life actively? As a person who was given special grace of God. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 12 through 17. This is a confession of Apostle Paul. He confessed like that. I thank Christ Jesus our Lord, who has given me strength, that He considered me trustworthy, appointing me to His service. Even though I was once a blasphemer and a persecutor and violent man, I was shown mercy because I acted in ignorance and unbelief. The grace of our Lord was poured out on me abundantly, along with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. Amen. We know who Paul was in the past before he encountered Jesus Christ. Before he encountered Jesus Christ, his name was Saul. And he was the most active person who persecuted, he was the most active person in persecuting Jesus Christ. He was a leader in arresting Christians, put them into jail and killed them. When Deacon Stephan was stoned to death, he was there. He was in charge of the cross taken off by the people who threw stone against Deacon Stephan. You know, Saul, the biggest persecutor against Christian, against Jesus Christ, he always stand the most prone in persecuting Jesus Christ. Job was finding out Christian and arresting them, put them into jail and killing. He's very zealous and very active in doing that. Why? Actually, he was a very zealous, Judaism believer. In Judaism, only Godfather is a God. Jesus Christ is not God. Holy Spirit is not God. So, Christian who believe Jesus Christ is a God, he thought that he thought that they are heretic group, heretic people. And Jesus Christ is a chief of heretic group, false prophet, chief priest of cult group. He thought like that. So, destroying Christianity is loyal to our God. He thought like that. That's why he was very active. But on the way to Damascus, you know, Jesus Christ personally met him. Amen? From heaven, Jesus Christ said to him, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Jesus Christ personally spoke to him. Amen? When he saw the heaven where the voice coming, there was a very strong light coming from heaven. When he saw that, his eye got blinded for 3 days. After 3 days, our Lord Jesus Christ sent his servant Ananias. Ananias came to Saul, put his hand on Saul's eye, something like a scale, fell down. And finally, Saul restored his eyesight. He didn't restore his eyesight physically. He restored his, he opened his spiritual eye. Amen?
Amen.
He become to real life. Jesus Christ is not chief person of cult group. He is really God and the creator of whole universe. He is the only savior for all human beings. He become to know that. He become to realize that. Amen?
Amen.
From that time, he actively devote his life to Jesus Christ. Especially when he realized that even he was the biggest persecutor of Christian, Jesus Christ forgive his sin. Not only that, Jesus Christ save him. Not only save him, Jesus Christ chose him as a biggest servant for testifying about Jesus Christ. When he realized that, he was so touched, so moved. That's why, even though he experienced so many suffering, hardship, many dangerous situations while he was spreading gospel, he didn't give up. He continually spreading gospel. Amen. If we see 2 Corinthians, Apostle Paul, he confessed how much great suffering he experienced while he is spreading gospel. How many times he experienced dangerous situation when he spread gospel. He described all those situations. Very dangerous situation, hard situation, difficult situation that he experienced while he spread the gospel. But he said he didn't give up. He, you know, never give up. Why? Because the grace he experienced from God is just so touching, so amazing. He confessed. Amen? God's grace, amazing God's grace given to him, he never deserved. He never qualified. Actually, he is the person, he is the person who should be punished most terribly. He is the man who mostly persecuted Christian. But that person, Jesus Christ just forgive, met him, and save him, use him, biggest servant. Amen? He was so moved, so touched that grace. That's why he fully give his life to precious work of God. Amen? Spread the gospel to the Gentile people through traveling many area, Asia Minor and Europe. Because of his four times of missionary journey, many area, Asia Minor, today Turkey area, Brother Bulacano nation, and also the Europe, there could be established many churches. There could be made many Christians. Amen? Through the Alphabets. We are same. Like Paul. Amen? We also given special grace from our God. Amen? We are not deserved. We are not qualified. But our God just has given special grace to him, to us. Amen? He has forgiven our sin. And also he has chosen us as his children and holy believers, his people. He has given us privilege to worship him, serve him. He has given us a wonderful, nice church building like this. If we remember all those grace, what should we do? We also should be same like a fool. Amen? Actively we should share the gospel. Amen? Jesus Christ said this. Luke chapter 14, 15 through 24. Jesus Christ said this parable. Rich man, he opened very big, nice banquet, and he already decided the people whom he will invite. He already decided some people to invite. So he made invitation. And he sent that invitation through his servant to those people whom he already decided to invite. So he sent his servant saying, you visit these people and invite them, saying to them, we prepare very nice banquet, very nice party. We prepare many food and also many good gift, many good thing. Please let them come. Invite them. So those servant immediately depart for those invitees, visit them and saying, my master sent us to you. My master prepared wonderful party, banquet, many food, many gift, wonderful things. Please come. And all those who are invited, they make an excuse. Sorry, I just married. I should be with my wife, my family. Sorry, I cannot go. Sorry, I just started my business. I'm very busy. Thank you for invitation, but cannot. Sorry, we just bought the land. We should start the farming. If we don't do that, the farming spoil, fail. Sorry, I have a promise with my friend. Everybody, you know, make excuse and reject the invitation. So all, you know, servant came back with bare hand. Bad news. Master, sorry, that person says busy, they cannot come. That person say, blah, blah, cannot come. The master very angry. Why? He prepared wonderful banquet, many, many food, buffet, many good gift, wonderful things, performances. But everybody reject. He's very angry. He's very disappointed. And now the master say to the servant, okay, then you go any place, street, station, or park, any person, homeless, beggar, you know, handicapped, poor people, never, the illegal dress of any kind of person, just invite. Just bring. So servant go out, they start to go street, you know, park, station, every place and start to invite. Beggar, homeless people, poor people, or any kind of people, please come. If you go, if you come, my master's house, you know, my master prepared very wonderful party. There are many, many delicious food as a buffet. Our master prepared many gift. Everything is free. Also wonderful performance. Just come, 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 come. So those people in the street, park, homeless, beggar, they start to come. So the banquet place, some occupied. But still, you know, there is a vacant place. Still there is a vacant place. When situation like that, now, master say to servant again, like this. He'll say, go out to the roads and country, rains and compel them to come in so that my house will be full. Amen? Amen. Actually, this is a parable. This is a parable. So what is the meaning of this parable? The master is our God. Amen? Amen. Our God prepared wonderful banquet in heaven. Amen?
Amen?
Eternal life. Wonderful banquet. Eternal banquet in heaven. Amen?
Amen.
Our God first decide to invite Jewish people. People of God. Chosen people. Our God prepare everything through sacrifice Jesus Christ for their salvation. So Jesus, our God first invited Jewish people, Israel people. But how they reply? They rejected Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
They rejected that God's invitation to wonderful banquet in heaven. When Jesus come, Israel, to save them, to invite them to heaven, one amazing banquet in heaven. But Israel people, they reject. They persecuted Jesus Christ. They killed Jesus Christ. They rejected Jesus Christ. Those invited people, those chosen people, they rejected Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Our God first invite them to heaven, but they rejected. That's why our God, you know, give that invitation to whom? Our God gave that invitation to Gentile people, non-Jewish people. We are all Gentile. Is there any Jewish people here? We are all non-Jews, right? I'm Korean. And our believers some from Philippines, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Bangladesh, you know, India, you know. We are all different. Amen? We are all not Jewish people. We are not Jewish blooded people. Amen? We are all Gentile people, Gentile. But because the Israel people, they reject the invitation to heaven, we are given the chance. Amen?
Amen?
Today, no matter whether they are Jews or not non-Jews, Gentile like us, if they heard that our God want to invite us to heaven, if you believe in Jesus Christ, repent your sin before Jesus Christ, you can go there, heaven. You are given ticket, invitation, ticket to wonderful, eternal banquet in heaven. We heard that, just accept. We believe in Jesus Christ. We are able to go there. Amen?
Amen.
The reason our God given this wonderful church, because our God want to invite many international people, many precious all nation people to banquet in heaven. Amen?
Amen?
Through this church. Amen?
Amen?
They are invited to hear. And they become to hear that Jesus Christ loves us. He is God, but He loves us. He died for our sin. And He is God. That's why 3 days after His death, He overcame death. He came to life again. So He made a perfect solution for our sin already 2,000 years ago. Anyone who hear this and believe it as true, repent their sin before Jesus Christ, accept Jesus Christ as that person's personal God and Savior and Lord, that person's sin totally can be forgiven, and that person can be given eternal life, that person can be accepted to eternal, wonderful banquet prepared our God in heaven. Amen?
Amen.
They are invited to hear this church, and they hear, they become to hear that good news here. And by the work of Holy Spirit, they are able to believe that. And finally, they also become to read to, they are also become to accept to eternal banquet in heaven prepared by our God. Amen?
Amen.
That's why our God given us this very wonderful church. Amen?
Amen?
That's why what we should do. We should fill this house. Fill this house. Many believers come today, but still there is a vacancy. Amen?
Amen?
Today, our God said to us, go out to the roads and country, rain, and compel them to come in so that my house will be full. Amen?
Amen.
It's not for only making Agape Church more number. It's for helping them go heaven. Amen?
Amen?
Helping them join wonderful eternal banquet in heaven. Amen?
Amen.
That's why our God say, go and invite them and fill my house so that they can go heaven. They can go wonderful eternal banquet party in heaven, not hell. If they don't go, where go? Immediately they become to go hell. In the hell, they supposed to suffer forever and ever. No matter how much regret in hell, already late. Go, once we go hell, why I come here? Why I suffering here? Please, one more chance. Finish. Never be able to give any more chance. Finish. Eternally should suffer there. Beloved, our prayers, our beloved parents, our beloved brothers, sisters, our beloved uncle, aunt, relatives, do you want them to go there? If we don't want, what we should do? Not only we support with money, we help them. We say about good news of Jesus to them. We should invite them to house of God. Amen?
Amen.
Here in Korea, Agape Church or any church, house of God, we should invite them. We should invite them. And we should invite them and let house of God fear. It means if house of God is fear, it means more people can go you know, eternal, wonderful banquet and party in heaven. Amen?
Amen.
That's why we should invite and we should fill house of God. Yeah. Not just make more number of the church, but for their salvation, for their blessing. Amen?
Amen.
So let's remember this Jesus Christ, our God's commandment. Go out to the roads and country lane and compel them to come in so that my house will be full. Brother, I propose our God prepare a wonderful party in heaven. We want more people go. There is no vacancy in heaven. Party. How? We invite people continually to this wonderful church. Here they hear the gospel and they believe in Jesus Christ so that they can join together with us. Wonderful banquet, eternal banquet, prepared our God in heaven. Amen?
Amen?
There, let's enjoy wonderful party, eternal party, forever with Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen?
And also Matthew 28, 18 through 20, Jesus Christ say, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make a disciple of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you already to the very end of the age. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, before he ascended to heaven, he gave this great commission. Great commission. It's like an assignment to do for all believers before Jesus Christ come again. People we Jesus Christ meet again when he come again. We should do this before Jesus come again. It's what we should do. It's our assignment. So, assignment our Lord Jesus has given us is not just making believers. Jesus Christ say, you make a disciple. You make a disciple. Agape believers, we should remember, believers, just believers and disciples different. If we hear the gospel and decide to believe, we can be believers, but disciples different. Very different. Disciple means the believer who really willing to do work of Jesus Christ. Devote themselves and who willing to do Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ's work. Helping people, serving people, and leading, help and serving people so that they can believe in Jesus Christ. They can be saved. And also we take care of them spiritually and also physically so that they can grow and they can be true believers who also try to do work of God. Who also try to share the gospel to them and help them to grow into the people, into the believers who again try to save others and help them to grow into another, you know, Jesus Christ disciple. Amen? The believers who are willing to do that, that's a disciple. Disciple means the person seems like he's a teacher. Amen? Jesus Christ focused on 12 people. Why? After Jesus Christ ascended to heaven, Jesus Christ won. These 12 people may do the same thing what Jesus Christ did. So that people continually hear the gospel and save. Beyond our purpose, Jesus Christ gave this assignment to every believers, every churches, Agape International Church. Amen? So we also should do diligently, peacefully until we meet Jesus Christ again. Making disciples of our own nation. Every nation, we make a disciples. Yeah. So Agape Church also should do that. We not just share the gospel and help them believe in Jesus Christ and finish. No. Of course, we should do that. But after that, we help them know Bible, help them know how to pray, help them know how to evangelize others, help them know how to raise other people spiritually so that that person again became Christian, the Jesus Christ disciple. Amen?
Amen.
That's why when we come here, when we are given special grace of God, now we pray and we have a vision. Actually, last 2 years, our God has shown the situation of Korea while we doing circuit evangelism once a month, through visiting many places here in Korea, some believers continually join, like Brother Ashi, Brother John, Brother Hani, or Deacon Danilo, Brother Dianca. Some believers very actively join our circuit evangelism and have experienced and have seen the situation many places here in Korea. You know, here in Korea, many places, there are many internet people gather together, walking, studying, but church and worship for them very rare, very small. That's why last year, why we have a you know, special program in Joam, Umsong, Nonsan, because through circuit evangelism, we visited that place, we shared the gospel, we amazed. There are many internet people gathering, staying, but church and worship for them only one or two, nothing like that. That's why even through those chances, Christmas time or Chuseok, we are not invite them, we are not show the gospel. Even one time, we wanted to do like that. That's why we did it like that. Anyway, situation is very, very urgent. Many area here in Korea. Below that purpose, you know, Korea, very Christianized nation. Many, many churches, wherever we go, even village, mountain area, fishing area, especially city, so many churches, mostly Korean churches. But even there are so many churches like that, there are many, you know, unreached people. Yesterday, one Bangladeshi person come. His name is Paskuni, Brother Paskuni, our Jeong Hyung-su 집사님 invited. He's a Muslim. We share the while talking, we share the gospel. He say, I stay in Korea 10 years. And he say, I never ever heard this kind of thing, even one time, during 10 years. I have heard that kind of thing not only one time, already many times. It means many international people, even they are living in Christian nation, they are like unreached people. They are people who are excluded from gospel. So, very urgent situation. They'll need many workers who willingly, voluntarily try to reach them and share the gospel, take care of them, educate them, teach them, so that they also grow. Not only just believing Jesus, but they also grow. And also they also became the people who are willing to help others spiritually. Jesus Christ gave commission to us, great commission to us to do that. Jesus Christ has, gave this assignment. Before I come, you do this. Make these efforts. So, Brother Apple Verse, we have been given special grace from our God. So we are enjoying eternal life, abundant life, the special spiritual status of children of God. We are so blessed. And also, especially this time, Agape Church is so blessed. We are ready to this wonderful church. But important thing is, then, now what we should do? Why our God has given this grace to us? After we are given this special grace, what we should do? We believe we should do this. Amen? Amen. Now, we should fill our house of God, not just so making more number our church, to bring more people to a wonderful banquet in heaven. Amen. And also in this place, this wonderful church, we should more pray, more work hard for doing this homework assignment given by our God, making disciples. Amen. Amen. So that you know, more God's worker can be preferred, can be made. They can reach more area where many internet people staying, remain. So there they can share the gospel to them and also help them to grow into another disciples. I believe Agape Internet Church should do this work of God continually, more actively from now on. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Actually, everything will be will of God. Everything belongs to God. But we have a vision and we praying. Now we are using third floor, right? But we pray. We using second floor, but we praying. Third floor also given by our God. We can use. So third floor, we praying. We make like a school. Like we make many lecture room. Yeah, lecture room. And we make like a theological school system, third floor. So our believer or other place, any internet people, maybe during the week work, but weekend come, they receive theological education. So they can, what is it, trained as a God's worker. So after some training, they are ordained servant of God, so they are sent to many area here in Korea where many internet people staying. There they can start a church, worship. So many internet people in those area, they can hear the gospel and save. Also they can also grow into Jesus Christ disciple. After come here, we become to have that vision. Yeah, so let's pray for that. We are weekend division. We are not enough. We are nothing but our God is a God of whole universe. Nothing impossible. If we really it is God's will of God, and if we our God won, we believe nothing impossible. He enoughly able to do that. Amen.
Amen.
We just commit everything to God. We just pray to God because we believe situation itself really need that thing. Many workers. Should be made. Many workers should be sent. Various area here in Korea. Yeah. Because many area, you know, there are many inter people staying, but no church, church and worship workers put them not enough. And Korea, now situation, population continually being decreased. The birth rate continually very low. So Korea not able to accept more international immigrants to this nation. No way. God make a situation like that. Because I believe God want many international people come to Korea and here they believe in Jesus Christ. They grow into Jesus Christ disciple. Amen? Because in their nation, Islam nation, Buddhism nation, Hindu nation, situation is very hard to be like that. Even they do, but it takes a long time. And they, you know, facing many, you know, the obstacles, hindrances, because of different religion and different, you know, religious background. Yeah. But here in Korea, very good situation. There's a freedom, and also very good situation. That's why I believe our God will try to bring more precious international people here in Korea. That's why, you know, the producing many workers for serving them, and through them, you know, more worships and church being established in many area here in Korea. It's a very necessary and very urgently and necessary. So. Let's, we can deficient. We are not enough, but our God can do everything. Our God is a God of the whole universe. So we just trust Him and we commit everything to Him and let's continue to pray for them. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, anyway, today we have thought this topic. We are all those who are given special grace of God, by grace of God. We are able to be forgiven our sin. We are able to give special. We are able to give eternal life, and we are enjoying abundant life. And if we are given special grace, what kind of Christian life we should live? was of God say about the answer to that topic, and especially we come here and we worship, we serve our Jesus also, special grace given to our God. So when we if we really remember this special grace of God, what kind of what we should do, and what kind of life, we Christian life we should live, we have a thought together through words of God. Once again, we remember our grace of God. So let's continually we live away from simple life, and let's live holy and righteous life. Let's seek for sanctified life. And also, we remember grace of God, and let's worship and worship our God actively. And through worship, we continually give thanks and honor, glory to our God. Let's be good worshipper to our God. And also, just as we are given special grace of grace from our God, also we also try to share our grace to many to our neighbors, and like Mary Magdalene, who devote her life actively to Jesus Christ after being given special grace, we also let's devote our life actively to precious work of God. Especially, we should devote our life to the work of spreading gospel and making disciples. Amen. Amen. Apostle Paul, he was the biggest enemy against Jesus Christ, but Jesus Christ had given special grace to him, so he was forgiven, and he was chosen as the biggest servant of God. After experiencing that grace of God, he fully devoted his life for testifying about Jesus Christ, spreading gospel to the Gentile people. So like a fool, we also try to devote our life actively for serving this precious work of God, of sharing the gospel and making disciples. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, let's pray.